Hi everyone, our campaign video blog this week is about the progress, the projects, and the efforts here in Sandy Hill. For those of you who are interested in Vanier and Lower Town profiles, we will do that in a few weeks, so stay tuned. Please continue to watch our videos. We're here in front of the biggest infrastructure investment in Sandy Hill, the new art gallery. The art gallery is a partnership with the University of Ottawa, with Le Germain Hotel and Dev McGill, a condo. It is the four stories behind me. It's a feature project. It's our local artists here in Ottawa. There's the Spencerville Collection, there's the Firestone exhibits. Come and visit. It's open 7 days a week, 9 to 9. And Thursday, there's some free childcare services. With the help of the community, with the help of the university, with the help of students, and with the help of the city, we're bringing partners together. I'm chairing a committee that's called Town and Gown. It's shown its success. It's a unique project here in Sandy Hill. We don't see it anywhere else in the city. It brings all the partners together. We work on initiatives that matter to the city. We work on initiatives that matter to the university, to students, and to residents. For the university, having a campus master plan, a housing master plan has been focal. Obviously, the LRT has helped with those strategies. With the city, it's been, and the community, it's been those pilot projects that are dedicated here for Sandy Hill, that it'd be the noise strategies, that it'd be the Welcome Week walkabout, for example, where just this week alone, we were walking in Sandy Hill, we visited 225 properties where in the last year we've had complaints of noise, of property standards, of garbage. We inform residents, we meet with landlords, but in this specific context, we want to make sure that they're informed as to their tenants' rights, and also that they know that we want to live in a community where everyone's welcome, where everyone's safe, where the quality of life continues to improve, and we want students to be part of that initiative and to be part of those strategies. Also on the zoning front, over the last 8 years, we've worked on 8 specific zoning strategies right here in Sandy Hill. We started off where developers were coming into the building code services, getting a permit, building. There was no oversight by the planning department, no political oversight, no community awareness or consultation. We're well beyond that. Bunkhouses are not permitted anymore. We've changed the regulations. We have site plan control here in Sandy Hill. We have the R4 study that is in place. So going forward, we are trying to preserve the character as much as we can. I want to thank the community for the ongoing support, the ongoing efforts to ensuring that we really preserve the community. We have 5 heritage conservation districts, and just this morning at council, we passed changes to add 2 new heritage conservation districts right here in Sandy Hill. Complete Street is a theme that we're all working towards as part of infrastructure renewal, ensuring that we have safe, reliable, active transportation network here in our city's downtown. We're focused for that for our entire community, but specifically here in Sandy Hill, our attention is obviously on the high pedestrian volumes that we have, also the importance of proper sidewalk maintenance throughout the winter. We need to see improvements, especially on those residential roads that see a lot of pedestrians, but that don't see the maintenance that is required, so we'll continue to push for that. And what we've seen is a wide range of improvements from pedestrian crosswalks. We've seen those on Stewart, on Lees, and we'll continue to see others in our community as the years go by. We see investments every year. We have the traffic calming measures, those flexi posts, that paint that is so relevant near schools where we want to slow down the speeds. We have the gateway signage, the 40 kilometers. Sandy Hill has the first in Ottawa. We'll have the gateway signage for all of our residential streets, meaning 40 kilometers, that's between Mann and Laurier Avenue range to King Edward. We also have the cycling improvements, those flexi posts on our cycling lanes, and the advisory lanes along Somerset, so that'd be the east-west bikeway going along Cumberland, Stewart, and Wilbraugh, that'd be Somerset East Avenue. We're working towards improvements to those connections, that'd be the multi-use pathway along light rail. How do we connect properly to the canal along Daly? That'd be the Chapel connection that will connect the east-west bikeway to the advisory lanes and Sandy Hill to Lower Town. Or that'd be the improvement to the Odawe Bridge connecting Vanier into Sandy Hill. Speaking of preserving our heritage, the built form, but there's also the social heritage of our community. We talk about the initiative called Prime Minister's Row. amazing mural along Lover's Lane. We want to continue to support initiatives like that where we showcase the best of our community, the best of our city and the capital city outside of the national features such as Parliament buildings. We have local history that is worth sharing, that is worth discovering for those who come to our city and for residents here in Sandy Hill. Again, we want to highlight the quality of life for all residents, that you be a senior, young family, that you be a student. We want to make sure that you have affordable housing, diverse housing options here in Sandy Hill. We also want to support business mix, local business mix along Mann, along Somerset, and along our main streets. I want to thank everyone. We'll continue to work in initiatives here in Sandy Hill with you, with the community, with residents, with businesses, with students, and with the city.